Kenyans are up in arms over continued borrowing by the government. 2 days after the International Monetary Fund approved the disbursement of 257 billion shillings to Kenya as a loan, which the GOK says will be used to bridge the gap in the fight against COVID-19. Kenyans are having none of it. Let me show you the figures here now. About 14,000 plus are signing an online petition and taking the protest online, calling for a stop. Let me put this into context for you so that you see. They want Kenya not to be given the 257 billion shillings from IMF. Here's the context. So between March 2020 and November 2020, before we get into March, there's about 971 billion shillings that was borrowed. That means that every month we were borrowing about 121 billion shillings. All right? All this was to fight COVID-19. Now, extend that to March 2020 from November, we've borrowed a further 257 billion shillings. That's the reason why Kenyans are up in arms. And this is part of what they're saying. Professor Alfred Omenya sent out a tweet earlier on saying, stop this madness. Kenyans are broke beyond imagination. The country is already bankrupt. There's still more coming through. Dr. Peter Ogola said, over 2 million Kenyans are out of work. We can't meet our daily expenses. We can't even put a simple meal on the table. We Kenyans are languishing in poverty, and yet we are still adding more burden to us. So all this was a call to IMF to stop giving Kenyans more money. However, not everybody agrees with this call. Roy Gitahi says, I'm finding this stop loaning Kenya hashtag both bold and foolish. Government rarely borrows without knowing where funds will go, but government doesn't know where revenue will come from. People are mad at the government and are going for the money, not realizing that the government needs it for service delivery. Speaking of which, the government said that the further 257 billion shillings is going to stand by four key areas. One of them, scaling up COVID-19 response currently, which we're dealing with the third wave. The second one is reduce the debt vulnerabilities in different institutions and the government as well. Funding structural and governance reforms. This is a controversial statement where people have been saying that they should stop the structural reforms right now. But the last one is supporting financial stability. So this is where the 247 billion, 57 billion shillings borrowed from the IMF is going. But Kenyans are not very happy with that. They're still continuing to sign the online petition, 14,000 plus and counting. All right. And on